Oh, do you have that?
The
waiting.
Traditional life, world language program, but with more songs and cultural activities. At first, it's not easy. Students are skeptical, and Chinese may be a difficult language. So in the beginning of the year, I start with songs, mostly songs, greeting songs, and then use pinyin as a bridge. So it's more letter-like, and then they can say the word. And I use calligraphy, and then help them to get more familiarized with the strokes, Chinese characters.
First, we started off going like how to say our names and how to introduce ourselves.
And after that, they can sing a few songs. We'll start to learn more vocabulary, the basic world language things, greetings, family members.
Extended family members, foods and how to ask to go out to eat and stuff.
Numbers, day and time.
But the characters in it, they're really hard to understand.
The thing is, the Chinese characters can combine with other characters to make words. So the mostly used Chinese characters is not a lot, about 600. Characters is like the woods of English to make the vocabulary they can read.
A lot of them are alike, so you get them mixed up.
I think the purpose of World Language Program is to try to see our own society from other perspectives. You see the whole universe, they have something in common. And so that's the cool part of the World Language Program.